Yo, yo, YouTube, what's crackin' like a jack smacking? It's Waffle Man with a video. And I made a review for my career about, what, 3-4 weeks ago? And it's now time to review NBA 2K17, my park. It's now been a couple of weeks. And I'm an all-star too now. And I've got the gist of my park, man. So this year, my park is pretty much, in my opinion, the same mode as almost last year. But let's talk about the good things about my park first. The good things. My park badges are new this year. I like the fact that you have to earn the badges through park, just like you have to earn badges through my career. But the my park badges are great as well. I think I like all of them, most of them. Right now I have 2 my park badges. The only thing about the my park badges is that once you get them for one of your characters, or you know, one of your my players, you don't get them for the other my player. Which, again, I mean, I understand that, but I think it should transfer over to all your my players, because if you're the same player playing on the same account, I shouldn't have to try to get my pop badges for every single player. That's going to take way too long and doesn't even make any sense. Another good thing is that park events, right? House Rules has its own park now, so if you don't want to play with the House Rules, you don't have to. Rival Day has its own park, so if you don't want to play Rival Day, you don't have to. And this year, you don't have to play, you don't have to be in the same affiliation with other people to play with them. One of the most requested things I wanted from 2K16 is for people to be able to play at parks without their affiliations. I thought the affiliations restrictions were just nonsense. And now you can also join your friends from the My Career. It's back. Wasn't 2K15, wasn't in 2K16, but now it's back. And this year the rep meter actually has a percentage, so now you actually know how far you are from being from the next rep. And you know, of course, there's more animations in this game, there's more clothes. You can buy and equip clothes while you're waiting for the game. Last year you couldn't buy clothes, you could just equip it. But this year you could buy and equip clothes. So yeah, that's a good thing. I mean, the Rival Day is good, it's back. I like the way they did it this year. But now let's get on to the bad and the ugly, man. First of all, of course, you know I've been talking about this for a couple of weeks now. The 3 same affiliations, man. Now I understand 2K15, 2K16, 2K17 might as well do the 3-peat. But still the same affiliations. So they don't have to change anything. They didn't change any affiliation symbols either. And also, the 3 same parks from 2K17. From 2K16, I mean. Now, why did they do that, man? I mean, from 2K15 to 2K16, you had new parks. Every year, 2K had a new park in the park ever since park was introduced. And this year, one of the most anticipated 2K games doesn't have a new park for the parks. Like, what? All the parks are the same parks from the last game. Why they did this? I don't know. It just seems lazy to me. Like I keep saying, I feel like it's lazy. Also, the House Rules Park is the same park from 2K15 that Old Town had after they won the Rival Day. And the Mountain Dew 3v3 Tournament Park is the same park the Old Town had that Old Town had from 2K15 before they won Rival Day. So I don't understand why we have parks from 2 years ago on this game just remastered. I mean, it doesn't make any sense to me. But like I said, I've been talking about this for a while. But like I said, man, it just comes across as lazy. Like, why? That's like getting Call of Duty Infinite Warfare, right? You know, different guns, different gameplay elements, but you have the same maps from Black Ops 3. If that would have happened, that community would be angry as hell. They would not stand for that. So I don't know why some people are accepting this, but they should not accept this. It's crazy. But the next thing, right? Park Events has every event. Now, like I said in the beginning of the video, Park Events was a good idea. But Park Events has every event. So you can't play Anti Up every single time if you want to. You know, Rival Days on like Saturdays and the Mountain Dew 3v3 tournament sometimes on Sundays. So once that park event is there, that's the only park event you can do. You can't play Anti Up all the time. So, you know, some people last year only played Anti-Up, which I think sucks for the people that like to play Anti-Up. Especially if you got, you know, certain times where you could be on. Sometimes you might never be able to play Anti-Up. So I think that was a bad idea. The next thing I want to talk about is the rep system and how you rank up, man. So they got the same rep from last year. The only thing they did was they removed the legend rep and they added the legend rep at the end So they added one extra rep again. I don't know why they did that, but the last rep gets you immortalized in 2K18. Like, anybody knows what that means. But I mean, you rep up the same way. You know, if you get more wins and you have a better teammate grade, you get more rep. If you lose, you get less rep. If you do bad, you might not get any rep. So I kind of like that they have the same kind of rep system. And also, you know, the rep rewards are pretty much the same rep rewards. Like, it's literally the same thing, man. At the same places, All-Star 2, All-Star 1, All-Star 3, they have literally the same thing. Now, of course, like I said, there's more animations and stuff like that, and flops and stuff like that, but still, mainly everything is almost the same. Superstar 3 is basically Legend 3. That's when you get your mascot. Superstar 1 is basically Legend 1 from last year. That's when you can take off your shirt. I mean, literally, man. And most of the symbols, most of the things are pretty much the same. Like, the only symbol that's different is the Superstar, because Superstar wasn't in the game last year, but that's because they put the Legend rep at the last rep. I don't even know why they did that. So, the rep rewards are basically the same. The only difference is you got the unlock upgrades. Once you get the Superstar, you start unlocking upgrades, but even that is a bad idea because not everybody plays My Park all the time. And some people play Pro-Am only, so it's like, why are you, why are you freaking penalizing people who play only Pro-Am compared to the people who play only Park? So the Park players are getting advantages because they play Park all the time. But if you play Pro-Am more than you play Park, you will never get the player upgrades from Park. So that doesn't really make any sense. I don't know why they did that. That's something they needed to change in the next game. Also, I think the VC prices are very expensive again. I can already tell that the VC prices, when you get to Legend 1, Superstar 1, Superstar 3, when you try to get those mascots and stuff, it's going to be very expensive. Because looking at what I have right now, All-Star 1, they actually raised the VC prices for the My Player jerseys from 5k VC last year to 75k to 7,500k VC this year. So that's a 2,500 VC increase for what? Doesn't make any sense. And again, Park cards are back in the game. Why? I don't know who requested this, but I don't think anybody wanted it. Then we got lag in Old Town and latency problems still existing in this game. So mainly My Park, if you really think about it, and I'm not trying to bash the game, because I'm still enjoying the game and I still play it, but anyways, I've been playing Battlefield 1 and Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2 a lot more in the past week. But I mean, it's really just the same game, man. I mean, it's the same thing from last year. They kept My Park under wraps for so long, and people wanted to know what's up with My Park, and we're getting hyped. But honestly, it's the same park from last year, man. There's literally almost, if you really think about it, no differences except more animations and the ability to play with everybody in the game now. I mean, really. And the My Park badges too. But other than that, it's literally the same thing. Copy and paste. I'm not trying to bash the game, but I'm just spitting facts here. It's clear. It's clear. But anyways, let me know what you think in the comment section. Right now, I'm out for now. Peace.